రాష్ట్రపతి ఇప్పుడు ధ్యానలింగ వెలుపలి పరిక్రమకు ఉపక్రమిస్తున్నారు. పంచభూతాల అధిపతి యొక్క ఆరాధన. మానవ వ్యవస్థలోని ఐదు మూలకాలను శుద్ధి చేసే ఈ ఆరాధన యోగ సంప్రదాయంలో భూతశుద్ధి అనబడేది ఒక ప్రక్రియ. భౌతిక శరీరంతో సహా సమస్త సృష్టికి ఆధారమైన ఈ ఐదు మూలకాలైన భూమి, నీరు, అగ్ని, గాలి, ఆకాశం యొక్క శుద్ధి శరీరాన్ని, మనసును, ఈ రెండిటికీ స్థిరత్వం చేకూరుస్తుంది. ముఖ్యంగా శారీరక రోగాలతో బాధపడుతున్న వారికి, బలహీనమైన శరీర వ్యవస్థ కలిగిన వారికి, మానసిక అసక్తతలు కలవారికి, కలత నిద్ర, ఇంకా నిరంతరం భయంతో ఉండేవారికి ఈ ఆరాధన ద్వారా ఐదు మూలకాల యొక్క లక్షణాలను మంత్ర, యంత్ర, తంత్ర, ఇంకా సర్వాంగ సాధన, ప్రతి మూలకం యొక్క భౌతిక రూపాన్ని, దానికి సంబంధించిన మంత్రము మరియు విస్తృతమైన క్రమానుగత కదలికల ద్వారా శక్తివంతమైన ప్రకంపనను జనింపజేసి మానవ వ్యవస్థలో ఆ మూలకాన్ని పొందుపరుస్తారు. భారత రాష్ట్రపతి ఇప్పుడు పంచభూత ఆరాధన కోసం వెళ్తున్నారు.
శివోహం శివోహం చిదానంద రూప శివోహం. తదేశ ప్రసూతస్య సకాశాద్ అగ్రజన్మనః స్వం స్వం చరిత్రం శేక్షరే పృథ్వ్యం సర్వమానవాః దృల్హాచిద్యా వనస్పతీన్ క్షమయా ధర్ధర్ష్యోజసాః యత్తే ఆవ్రస్య విద్యుతో దివో వర్షంతి వర్ష్టయః.
అన్నాద్భవంతి భూతాని పర్జన్యధన్న సంభవః యజ్ఞాద్భవతి పర్జన్యో యజ్ఞకర్మ సముద్భవః. ఆపోధ్యాన్వచారిషం రసేనా సమగస్మహి మయస్వానగ్నాగహి తమాంసా.
స్తుత్యాద్యావత్ పృథివీభ్యామంతరిక్ష్యమ్యుద్యావే హవీంషి సూరీశ్వర. భూమిమంగళం
భూమిమంగళం
ఉదకమంగళం
ఉదకమంగళం
అగ్నిమంగళం
అగ్నిమంగళం
వాయుమంగళం
వాయు
The Honorable President of India and Sadhguru have made their way to the Mahashivratri grounds now to inaugurate the night-long celebrations and unveil the
நடக்கவிருக்கும் இந்த விழாவினை துவக்குவதற்கு சத்குரு அவர்களும் மாண்புமிகு குடியரசுத் தலைவர் அவர்களும் இப்பொழுது நம்முடன்
இருக்கின்றனர். ராம்நாத் கோவிந்த் at the Adi Yogi. To enjoy the grace of Shiva. We begin our celebrations tonight by requesting the Honorable President, Mr. Ramnath Kovind,
to please plant
a sapling of the Malsari tree, also called the Magaripun.
Magaripun
is adding soil and water to this magnificent specimen chosen in memory of those recently martyred CRPF personnel at Latepura in Pulwama. Innocent lives that were snuffed out by the unkind act of terrorism that afflicted parts of our country. We join our President in paying homage to their lives. We pray for peace and harmony in our country. We remind ourselves of the sacrifices of these personnel and in a way add to the consecration or efforts. And as we do so, we take a few moments and keep them in our thoughts in silence.
ஒரு சில வினாடிகள் மௌன அஞ்சலி செலுத்துவோம்.
Sadhguru will now lead the President to the Yogeshwara Linga.
Sadhguru avargal ippozhudhu maanbumigu kudiyarasu thalaivarai
Mahayoga Yagya.
Mahayogya Yoga Yagyavai thuvakki vaikka Yogeshwara Lingavirku azhaithu selvargal.
The Yogeshwara Linga, installed near the Adi Yogi, consecrated by Sadhguru as a manifestation of the five of the major chakras in the human system.
நிறுவப்பட்டுள்ள யோகேஸ்வர லிங்கம் மனித உடலில் உள்ள ஐந்து சக்கரங்கள் உச்ச நிலையில் உள்ளபடி பிரதிஷ்டை செய்யப்பட்டுள்ளது.
The Honorable President lighting the sacred fire to commence the Mahayoga Yagya across the world, where 1 million people will take an oath to teach a simple form of yoga to at least 100 people each in the coming year, and touch at least 100 million people before the next Mahashivratri. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of India, with Sadhguru on stage. May I request you all to please rise and remain standing.
Kindly remain standing now and join in the singing of the national anthem.
தேசிய கீதம்.
ஜனகணமன அதிநாயக ஜய ஹே பாரத பாக்ய விதாதா பஞ்சாப சிந்து குஜராத் மராட்டா திராவிட உத்கல வங்கா விந்திய ஹிமாச்சல யமுனா கங்கா உச்சல ஜலதி தரங்கா தவ சுபநாமே ஜாகே தவ சுபாசிஷ மாகே காஹே தவ ஜய காதா ஜனகண மங்கள தாயக ஜய ஹே பாரத பாக்ய விதாதா ஜய ஹே
சவிநயம் words and welcome him.
कालो न जानाति तव जननम्, कालो न जानाति तव समापनम्, दृष्टो मया तव महाकार योगेश्वर काल काल योगेश्वर काल काल
Namaskaram to everyone. It's our profound privilege and pride to have the President, the Honorable President of India here. Welcome, sir, to the Sevaka Center. And Honorable Governors, Ministers of the State and Union, and many other dignitaries, and above all, the devotees of Shiva who are here. Welcome to all of you. Adiyogi, though a historical figure, he is not of the past but of the future, because never before humanity was psychologically and socially ready to approach their well-being in a scientific manner. In pursuit of human well-being, there have been many movements. To start with, it led to belief systems and looking up in pursuit of human well-being, divided humanity in the name of religion, caste, creed, my God versus your God, my heaven versus your heaven. You must understand, even the heavenly real estate is divided. Much blood has been spilled and continue to be spilled even today, because we looked up in pursuit of human well-being. Then as science and technology touched us, we started looking for human well-being around us, outside of us. With that, many conveniences and comforts have come, but well-being has not come. But above all, in pursuit of human well-being, we have just ripped this planet apart. We have brought this planet to a brink of ecological disaster, because human well-being can be sought only within. Because human experience is caused from within. Whatever happens to you, pain or pleasure, joy or misery, agony or ecstasy, can only happen from within you. So this is what Adiyogi represents. 112 different ways in which you can approach your well-being. In is the only way out. This is the fundamental message. In is the only way out. If you're seeking well-being, in is the only way out. So this movement of moving people from religion to responsibility, that is, instead of passing responsibility up in the sky, seeing that every thought that we generate, every emotion that we generate, every action that we perform has a significant impact on yourself and everybody around yourself and the very world in which we live. To bring this back, that human well-being can only happen because of human beings. This is what Adiyogi represents. For the first time, over 15,000 years ago, he brought this idea to humanity, that if you are willing to strive, whatever you think are limits of nature, all those limits can be crossed if only you're willing to strive. This is the fundamental message of Adiyogi. And today, Adiyogi will be giving you a Divya Darshan, something that you have not seen till today. Are you ready, huh? That doesn't sound ready to me. So I will request our Honorable President to unveil this Divya Darshanam. Before that, we are at a time in this country, the nation is going through certain pains on our borders on a daily basis. Our young men are dying. Well, these are problems we have, I would say, endured or even nurtured for the last 70 years, unfortunately. So at a time like this, the making of a nation becomes very important. If we want to make a great nation, we just have to build great human beings. This is what the science of yoga is all about. This is what Adi Yogi represents, how to build great human beings so that we can build a great nation and a great world. Now, the Honorable President will unveil the Divya Darshanam. All of you, keep your eyes on Adi Yogi. Ellarume Adi Yogi paathu ukkaranum oru Divya Darshanam ippo ungalku. Being appeared in the upper regions of Himalayas. No one knew who he was, where he came from. The origins of this spectacular being were unknown. When his ecstasy allowed him some movement, he danced wildly. Intensity peaked, he became utterly still. People saw that he was experiencing dimensions that no one had ever known or able to fathom. His ecstasy and intensity allowed him to transcend his physical form. Witnessing an individual human in union with the cosmos, they called him a yogi, as he was the first one, the Adi Yogi. When his stillness lasted for years on end, curious onlookers melted away. Only seven seekers remained, as they could not tear themselves away from him. Transmitted the profound science of yoga in its full depth and dimension. He expounded 112 methods of attainment, offering his disciples access.
It was a vision of the very core of the cosmos in all its profundity and magnificence, a vision of the unfathomable mysteries of the universe, a most overwhelming vision the sages and Devi Parvati had ever witnessed. Devi Parvati, seeing Adiyogi reveling in ecstatic states, said, "I want to have what you have. Show me the way." Adiyogi absorbed her and made her a part of himself, and hence he is the Ardhanari, the ideal man, where one half of him is woman. seeing the splendor of this magnificent union, Bhanas, his constant companions, asked, "What about us?" Adiyogi said, "Just drink of me," which drove them into intoxicated raptures. Seven sages, the Saptarishis, took the sacred science of yoga in all its forms to human habitations across the planet, which turned into crucibles of civilization. This spectacular being is not of the past, but the future of humanity. To move humanity from hallucinations of ups and downs to nameless ecstasies of one's interiority.
Mahadevaya Namaha. Diana also. Please. Sir, if you can address the gathering, sir, please.
Governor of Tamil Nadu, Sri Banwarilal Purohit ji, founder Isa Yoga Center, Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev ji, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Namaskaram, Vanakkam, and good evening to all of you present here in such large numbers from across the country and from so many nations. I am very happy to be among you on this pious day. Our country is a land of faith and spiritualism. Probably no other nation has as many diverse festivals and celebrations as we have. Faith and spiritualism also give India a certain determination and an inner resolve. Among our festivals, Mahashivaratri is one of the most endearing, enduring, and significant. Millions of devotees celebrate this festival as a day to introspect and reflect upon the values synonymous with Lord Shiva. Today, I am reminded of a few lines penned by the great Hindi poet Rashtrakavi Maithili Sharan Gupt. I quote, Manoj Dugdh Se, Danuj Rudhir Se, Amar Sudha Se Jeete Hain, Kintu Halahal Bhav Sagar Ka Siva Sankar Hi Peete Hain. I unquote. These lines imply that ordinary human beings lead an honest life, seeking only what rightfully belongs to them. Those who are depraved live by snatching from others. And the truly immortal ones, like the gods in heaven, have access to nectar, that is, they live with the best of everything available to them. But Lord Shiva, the all-pervasive and benevolent one, takes upon himself to clear away the poison, that is, sorrow, sufferings, negativity, grief, etc., present in the world. Literally, these lines refer to the act of Lord Shiva consuming poison that emerged during the Samudra Manthan in order to save the creation. Consuming that poison made his throat turn blue, giving him the name Neelkantha. At the very basic level, these lines give the message, Jeena usi ka jeena hai, jo auron ki khatir jeete hai. That is, a worthy life is one that is lived in the service of others. That was the message of Neelkanth. Consistent with his message, each one of us should strive to serve humanity in whatever way it is possible. I am aware that Sadhguru and the ISA Foundation are making laudable contribution in this regard with several initiatives to promote human well-being. Ladies and gentlemen, Lord Shiva has many forms, and one of these is his form as Ardhanariswar. In this form, one half is a man's body and one half a woman's. This indicates that both masculine and feminine aspects need to be in balance for a man, human personality and for a society to prosper. Today, the entire world talks of women empowerment, but emphasizing it has always been a part of our cultural ethos. Historically, the qualities of Lord Shiva have attracted devotees across the world. A few months ago, I had the opportunity to visit the ancient My Son temple complex in Vietnam. This temple complex is a reminder of the unique culture that developed on the coast of present-day Vietnam thousands of years ago, a culture that drew from the spiritual depth of Hinduism in India. It was truly remarkable to see the Shivalinga and the many sculptures of Shiva adorning this ancient temple complex built by the Champa kingdom. There are many more examples from the ancient world. From Afghanistan to China and Japan, devotees have built temples for Shiva in the past. This evening, all across India, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari and from Somnath in Gujarat to Kamakhya in Assam, we shall hear the chants of Om Namah Shivaya. Ladies and gentlemen, I have been told that in yogic culture, Lord Shiva is considered the first yogi or Adi Yogi, the originator of yoga. Sadhguru says that Shiva as Adi Yogi brought the possibility for human beings to evolve beyond their present limitations by doing the necessary work upon themselves. It brings great joy to me to be here with you today in the presence of the magnificent 112-foot statue of Adi Yogi. We are at the foothills of the Vilayanagiri Mountains, the Dakshin Kailas or Kailas of the South. Legends say that Adi Yoga stayed here for some time. I had the privilege to visit Kailas Mansarovar in 2006, and today I am in the presence of the Kailas of the South. Personally, the visit here today completes a spiritual cycle for me. I am experiencing the very same feelings that I had experienced on myself when I visited Kailas Mansarovar. This event that Sadhguru has conceived is an opportunity to experience the grace of Mahashivaratri. There is another connection that comes to mind. It is believed that Lord Shiva helped bring the mighty Ganga to us, and Sadhguru has been among those who are rallying to rejuvenate our rivers. Protection of our rivers and environment is a very noble and worthy objective. I am glad that Sadhguru has made this objective a part of his mission. I am extremely happy to see so many young faces here today. It is heartening to know that you are imbibing yoga at an early age. I compliment you for investing your time in your well-being early in life. I am confident that our youth will play a crucial role in shaping the future of not only India, but of the entire humanity itself. The presence of so many young people here says a lot about the work of Sadhguru and the ISA Foundation. Sadhguru has ensured that the age-old spiritualism and values of India are made accessible to the youth, both in India and elsewhere. Sadhguru has emerged as a spiritual bridge that brings our long-cherished values, wisdom, and knowledge to the youth of today in a language that they understand. As I conclude, I congratulate Sadhguru and all the volunteers of ISA Foundation who would have worked for making this event so grand. I wish all of you the very best for Mahashivratri as well as for all future endeavors. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Rini can announce the book.
The Honorable President, Sri Ramnath Kovindji, will now present Sadhguru with a collection of selected speeches made by him from July 2017 to July 2018, compiled in a volume titled The Republican Ethic.
Thank you very much. It's an immense pleasure for all of us, Honorable President sir, to have you here in the presence of Adiyogi and the Mahayoga Yagna that you have lit is our commitment to the world to offer the yogic sciences irrespective of race, religion, gender, caste or creed, to every human being. This is one thing that must happen to human beings. What great things they may do or they may not do is left to them, but making human experience of being here on this planet a pleasant one is a fundamental right that every human being should know how to live here peacefully and joyfully. That is the commitment, and we are extremely grateful to you, sir, for having lit the Mahayoga Yagna, and also for unveiling the Adiyogi Darshanam that people will immensely enjoy. I hope you enjoyed the show that was done. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very, very much for being here. Please rise for the national anthem, everybody, please. எல்லாரும் நினைக்கணும். Please give a big hand to the Honorable President.
Ladies and gentlemen, kindly remain in your places until the President and other guests have left the vicinity. We will be continuing with our program. I request you to please remain in your seats. Please be seated and enjoy the grace.
Adiyogi.
நாட்டிய குழுவினர் இன்று நம்முன் தங்களது பிரம்மாண்ட நடனத்தினை
அரங்கேற்றவிருக்கின்றனர்.
அதாவது நீலகண்டனாம் சிவன், இதுவே இவர்களது இன்றைய படைப்பு. தக்ஷா சேத் கம்பெனியின் முதன்மையான நடனக்கலைஞர்
தக்ஷா சேத் ஏக் மஷ்ஹூர் நர்தக் ஹை ஜின்கா கேரியர் லக்பக் 5 தசக் லம்பா ஹை. ஈஷா ஷெர்வானி தக்ஷா சேத் கம்பெனி கி முக்கிய நர்தக் ஹை ஔர் ஆஜ் भारत की एक प्रमुख हवाई मुद्राएं करने वाली नर्तक हैं. उन्होंने 15 सालों से ज्यादा समय तक कथक, छऊ, कलरीपयट्टू, योग और साथ ही रस्सी और खंबे वाले मल्लकंभ में ट्रेनिंग ली है. दक्षा शेठ जी ने 20 वर्षों तक कथक की दुनिया में गौरवपूर्ण प्रतिष्ठा प्राप्त करने के बाद अपनी नृत्य कला में अन्य विभिन्न नृत्य शैलियों को शामिल किया. वे अपने नृत्य में लगातार नए प्रयोग करने के लिए जानी जाती हैं. वे भारतीय नृत्य में हवाई मुद्राओं की शुरुआत करने वाली और अपनी प्रस्तुतियों में अनेक शैलियों का मेल करने वाली पहली नर्तक थीं. टाओ इसारो पश्चिमी ऑस्ट्रेलिया और केरल में रहने वाले भारतीय ऑस्ट्रेलियाई तालवाद्य यंत्र वादक, संगीतकार और संगीत निर्माता हैं. उनका जन्म दक्षा शेठ डांस कंपनी के कला से जुड़े परिवार में हुआ था. उन्होंने 13 वर्ष की उम्र में मंच पर प्रदर्शन की शुरुआत की और 9 वर्ष की उम्र से शुरू करते हुए 30 देशों में 1000 से ज्यादा प्रस्तुतियां दे चुके हैं.
द लीड एरियल डांसर इन इंडिया टुडे डॉटर ऑफ दक्षा सेठ एंड देवी सारो एन ऑस्ट्रेलियन बोर्न म्यूजिशियन शी हैज ट्रेन्ड फॉर ओवर 15 इयर्स इन कथक छाओ Kalaripayattu, yoga, as well as rope and pole Mallakhamb. Isha has also participated in Indian cinema and starred in Indian films such as Kisna and Luck by Chance. With her is Daksha Seth, her mother, a renowned dancer with a career spanning over 5 decades. Daksha carved a prestigious reputation for herself in the world of Kathak for 20 years before she began to explore a variety of dance styles in her choreography. She's also the first Indian woman soloist in Chau, an ancient dance form from eastern India influenced by the martial arts. Tao Isaro, an Indian and Australian percussionist, composer and music producer based in Western Australia and Kerala, was born into the artistic tribe of the Daksha Seth Dance Company and made his debut on stage at the age of 13. He has first performed with the company as a dancer, then as a sound controller, and finally finding his place on stage through music. A group celebrate the presence dedicated to Sadhguru. This is an offering on Mahashivratri by the Daksha Seth Company. Music is composed by Devi Saro and Tao Isaro. Choreography is by Daksha Seth and performed by Isha Sharwani, Tao, Ramesh Ram and Ratesh Sumangali. Blue Throat Shiva.
Shiva 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 Shankara 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 Shiva 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 जीव शंकर जीव 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 शंकर आदिदेव जीव 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 शंकर जीव 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 शंकर बोले नाद जीव 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 शंकर जीव 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 शंकर नीलकंठ बोल नाद जीव 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 शंकर जीव 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 शंकर आदिदेव शंभो बोल नादा योगी महादेव शंभो बोल नादा योगी महादेव जीव 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 शंकर जीव 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 शंकर बोल नाद जीव 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 शंकर जीव जीव शंकर नीलकंठ जीव 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 शंकर शंकर शंभो भोलनाथ योगी महादेव शंभो भोलनाथ योगी महादेव जीव 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 शंकर जीव 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 शंकर योगी महादेव
Thank you. beautifully crafted space for self-transformation.
India has always been that this is a land of seekers.
The four fundamental forms in which you can seek is, you can seek through activity of your body, it's called karma yoga. You can seek through your intelligence, it's called jnana yoga. You can seek through your emotion or devotion, which is called bhakti yoga. Or you can seek by transforming your energies, which is called kriya yoga. Probably this is the only place where all the four dimensions of yoga are offered in one place.
मैं आप सभी को आमंत्रित करता हूँ। हम सप्ताह के सातों दिन खुले रहते हैं। प्लीज इसका लाभ उठाएं जब भी आपके लिए संभव हो।
When you are 5 years of age, in 24 hours time, how many moments of joy you knew? And today, how many moments of joy you know? Has it gone up or gone down? What you call as joy? Has a chemistry to it. What you call as misery has a chemistry to it.
We will teach a certain process which is known as the Shambhavi Mahamudra. कहते हैं
ये आपकी ऊर्जाओं को सक्रिय करने का एक तरीका है जिससे आप अपनी रासायनिक प्रक्रिया को आनंदमय बना सकते हैं.
मेरी ऊर्जा का स्तर बहुत बढ़ गया है और ध्यान और एकाग्रता का स्तर भी बढ़ गया है.
कॉर्पोरेट जगत में बहुत गहराई से शामिल होने की वजह से मुझे ये लगता है कि शांभवी महामुद्रा अपनी भावनाओं पर काबू पाने का और दबाव को दूर रखने का एक बहुत बड़ा अवसर है.
Hey, tonight you're not going to sleep, are you?
How can you? It's Mahashivratri. Tonight you snooze, you lose. Want to know why?
On this day, there is a phenomenal upsurge of energy. So having realized this, the yogic tradition set this up, that nobody should lie down on this night. Your spine should be vertical so that an upward moment happens. Children are told on this night to go and throw stones on people's homes, and on that day you can do this mischief and no crime. Wherever you are watching this event, every hour make a call to all the people that you care for. Let them curse you, it's okay, but they sit up. You are rendering a great service to them. I want all of you to pay.
Hailing from Fakira Kheta Khan, are schooled in the Manganiyar tradition of Rajasthani folk singing, which they also call Sufiana music. Apart from locally inspired lyrics, they sing songs that have been passed down from generations and also specialize in the art of devotional folk music, singing compositions by the likes of Kabir Das, Sur Das, Tulsi Das and Mirabai. Sufi renditions of poets Bulle Shah, Amir Khusro, the more popular inspirations in their repertoire. Fakira Kheta and have been a boy. In 2000 and the Ustad Bismillah Khan Yuva Award in 2000.
Agli Prastuti hai Fakira Kheta Khan aur group ki, jo Rajasthan ke Baadmer jile se hain. और राजस्थानी लोक संगीत की मांगनियार परंपरा में प्रशिक्षित हैं, जिसे वे सूफियाना संगीत भी कहते हैं. स्थानीय संगीत और पीढ़ियों से चले आ रहे गीतों के अलावा फकीरा खेता खान और उनका ग्रुप भक्ति लोक संगीत के भी महारथी हैं और वे कबीरदास, सूरदास, तुलसीदास और मीराबाई आदि के गीत गाते हैं. उनकी बुल्ले शाह, अमीर खुसरो और लतीफ के सूफी संगीत की प्रस्तुतियाँ काफ़ी मशहूर हैं. फकीरा खेता खान और ग्रुप को कई पुरस्कार दिए जा चुके हैं, जिनमें वर्ष 2016 में दिया गया प्रतिष्ठित शान ए राजस्थान अवार्ड और वर्ष 2010 में दिया गया उस्ताद बिस्मिल्ला खान अवार्ड शामिल है. आइए स्वागत करते हैं फकीरा खेता खान और ग्रुप का.